The current economic situation in the country, including its debt burden and income, was discussed in Parliament today. The discussion arose during the debate to approve several orders, including the reduction in the annual license fee of bottling toddy. We earn only 18% in direct income tax. This is quite an unfortunate and unacceptable situation, which is why we have to reduce indirect taxes to increase our direct taxes. There were around 400,000 tax files, but with the introduction of the new Inland Revenue Act, 69,000 new tax files have been opened at the Inland Revenue Department since the 1st of April to day before yesterday. We are paying a debt of 1.9 trillion rupees this year. It goes without saying that 83% of this debt amount are loans obtained before 2015. In 2019-20, we have to pay over 4 trillion rupees. Those are the Rajapaksa's loans. But without saying this isn't our loans and evading it, we are paying them as well and continuing to grant concessions to the people. If you look at the previous budget, you haven't been able to achieve the target you hoped for. Reaching targets is my responsibility and I will take care of it, do not worry. But targets aren't what is important to me, unlike you who have black money and charge massive taxes. What is important to me at this point of time is giving the people concessions. Our government is more sensitive towards the people than your government. You taxed everyone. If a separate debate is given, I will give you a list of those who were exempted of taxes. I do not think of targeting them. The entire country ultimately was buried in a mound of debt. You speak today like recently reborn babies. So wouldn't this make me angry? They are talking like saints today, like a group who rule this country in an exemplary manner. They are the ones who ruin this country. We will not let that happen again. Today the prices of vegetables and 250 grams of rice are beyond 60 to 70 rupees. It is easy for Parliament to get together and impose a tax. At a time when the cost of living has risen, the dollar is at 161 rupees. The country's total debt has risen this year because of the depreciation of the rupee in 2018. The central bank says foreign debt alone is 211 billion rupees. As the rupee depreciates further, prices of imported goods increase as well, making the people even more bankrupt than they already are. What happens then? The cost of 250 grams of vegetables is 60 rupees. You say crime has increased. What else can the people do? Of course they will steal. People's stomachs wouldn't get full just because Parliament convened.